remember the unit for measuring force? That's right, it was Newton's. Newton was a famous physicist and mathematician who made the different laws of motion that allow us to understand how forces act upon us. This video will give you an understanding of Newton's laws of motion. Newton's first law of motion is that of inertia. Inertia is the ability of an object to remain at rest or in uniform motion. Therefore, any undisturbed object has inertia. If you want a detailed explanation on why objects stay still or move, you can watch our video on net forces. Newton's second law of motion was that a force is directly proportional to mass and acceleration. Acceleration can be simply defined as the rate of change of velocity. Let's say you threw a tennis ball and a paperclip with the same force. Which object would accelerate faster? The paperclip would have a higher acceleration. Why does this happen even though there are equal forces being applied on both objects? This is because the mass of the objects is different. If you hold a tennis ball and a paperclip, which would be heavier? That's right, the tennis ball would be heavier. This is because it has a higher mass. Mass can be defined as the amount of matter in any object. If you think about it, it will require more force to move more mass. That's why the same force being applied on two objects with different mass results in different accelerations, because same acceleration would mean more force being applied to the object with a larger mass. Hence, Newton's second law. Newton's third law of motion states that all forces have an equal and opposite reaction. This means that if a force is exerted upon an object, it will have an equal force exerted back on it, but from the opposite direction. Let's take the example of a person swimming. While swimming, they put their hand in front of them and push back to move forward. Why is that even though when they push their hand backward, they move forward instead? Let us break this down using the third law of motion. The force being exerted here is that of the swimmer pushing the water backwards. The equal reaction to this would be an equal force applied on the swimmer by the water. The opposite reaction to backward is forward. Therefore, if you put this together, a force exerted on the swimmer that pushes them forward. To recap, Newton has three laws of motion that describe the world around us. The first law of motion states that all objects are in a state of inertia until a force is acted upon it. The second law of motion states that force is equal to mass into acceleration. The third law of motion states that all forces have an equal and opposite reaction.